More complex schemes can be devised with more than two firms, many alternative prices, differentiated products, and non-price competition. Or sometimes they might just do funny things like do threats and promises as well. An oligopolist can make a threat or a promise that you will act in a certain way. So as long as the threat or promise is credible, the firm can gain and it will influence the rival's behavior. It can stop the rival from doing something and actually they can prevent them from going to war. Take for example a very large oil company like Shell. Well, the Shell can state that any petrol station nearby, should it change its prices, Shell will match the price change by any competitor in a given radius. Now, assume that the competitors believe this promise to be true. Then few other firms will lower their prices to be lower than Shell's, knowing that Shell will match their promise and eventually result in a price war and take away whatever benefits that they have gained from the lower prices. But a threat has to be credible. If not, people are just, you know, I don't care about what you say. So here the threat is credible because Shell is large. And thus, even if it lowers prices, it can probably take the damage. It can take a lot of suffering and it can probably suffer longer than most companies out there. So it can drive the opponents out of the markets before they can recover. Sometimes, some other firms may move first, earlier than others, and in this case, they give a first mover advantage. So game theory is a rather complex branch of mathematics that a lot of economists and mathematicians spend lots of time on. But we can always assess the usefulness of game theory at this point of time. See, the advantage is that a firm does not need to know which response the rivals will make, but it actually does need to measure the effect of each possible response. You actually need to quantify all the possible scenarios. And that is quite impossible in real life. So most oligopolies actually just compete and realize that they're not making a lot of money, so they collude again. After a while, someone gets itchy, competes again, spoiling the collusion, and they collude again. So like I said, it's very much like a bunch of kids playing on a playground. But nonetheless, we still think that the game theory is the most useful and direct tool to analyze oligopolies, because after all, it's just a bunch of people fighting and trying to think about, you know, what other people does. And it highlights the interdependence factor so well, which is why we chose to use game theory to illustrate oligopolies.